He was quiet. He was a man of many talents. He was also a good friend.
Started flying when he was 16, in his mid-20s. He had already had more than 70 combat flights, had bailed out.
Willing to tackle anything. The best engineering test pilot I ever worked with. He flew absolutely impeccably.
Took me on my first supersonic ride in a 104. That's the greatest flight I ever had.
Every time an airplane flew over, he would look up at it.
While we are changing our name, the work we do remains consistent. We fly, we explore, we measure, we reveal, and we discover the overlooked and unexpected for the benefit of the nation and for the benefit of humankind.
We're going to ride off into the sunrise.
A36, left 33.
Got it. Yeah, we've got lock.
Non-conditions.
N5, run complete.
Copy, 0.95 shown here, run complete.
Mission controllers, this is flight on data 1. We are ready for the supersonic 1.
High-speed research is hopefully at one point in time going to allow supersonic flight commercially over the U.S. and throughout the world.
Up. 12 o'clock, 5 miles northbound, Navajo, 8,500. November 02, Sierra, traffic, 2 o'clock.
Clip com 139.
Visual about 3.2.
Going to be spot on, perfect.
Lift off, initial climb mission phase. Pilot monitor, verify guidance, advise when a normal flight.
Passing through 10,000.
Nav 02, gear is cycling.
Yep, it looks good to me.
Perfect.
Crandall is the closest to bird flight that humans have ever gotten as far as aircraft goes. Not having a vertical tail would decrease the drag of an aircraft immensely.
You guys made history today. No one has ever proven that vortices go anywhere except at the wingtip.
You're on 50 knots.
Fiber optic system tells us how much the wing is bending in real time. This technology eventually should be applied to completely flexible wings. That's the future.
The new flaps have promised to be lighter, more efficient, and also quieter, more like a bird, morph without any use of hinges and joints and things like that.
We're gonna continue ahead here for about another couple miles. Check out the airplane before I make a turn.
Steady heading side slip to the left first. We'll hold it for 10 seconds and try to get about half yaw where we're going. Pitch stability is good. Roll and yaw.
Runway is clear. Go for takeoff.
All of the airborne science aircraft from ER-2 to C-20 to DC-8 to Global Hawk, they all play an important role.
You guys ready?
Ready.
Start recording.
Okay, stop recording. What are our temperatures? 34, 33.
I've got rising terrain, 12 o'clock,
yep.
7 miles.
Tally-ho.
Tally-ho, and I'm going to start climbing here.
We'll clear it.
All right, looks like it's a wings level and rock level.
Signs of your flight.
It's great. Which turn?
We'll be right back.
much just about the process of science, and that in itself is something you can bring back to the classroom.
FIFI is an imaging spectrometer in the far infrared. We can reach wavelengths that other instruments cannot reach.
Inflatable systems allow us to build bigger heat shields to decelerate larger masses so that we can support the systems that are required for human space exploration.
Tower NASA UAS Airborne UX Work Area surface to 2,000 feet. Relays!
Green light, air 20.